كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح والأحزاب من بعدهم.
My brothers in Islam, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came to teach us how to live the best life. And not only the best life, but to live the most happiest life. Not only the most happiest life, but to live the most content and the most satisfying life. Yes, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us to live the best life and to be the best people on the surface of this earth, to live the most happiest life and to live as the most happiest people on the surface of this earth, to live a content life and to be the most content people on the surface of this earth. As contentment, as Imam Shafi'i says, kanzun la yafna, kanzun la yafna, it's a treasure that never ends, an everlasting treasure. ارضى بما قسم الله لك تكن أغنى الناس. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, accept and be content, be satisfied with what Allah Azza wa Jal had decreed for you, or what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had sustained you. What happens in return? You become the most happiest person. Accept, be content, be satisfied. Be content, be satisfied with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had written for you. What happens? You'll be the most happiest person. You'll be the most happiest person on the surface of this earth if you accept what Allah Azza wa Jal had decreed for you. For that, my brothers in Islam, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us the way of contentment, the way of happiness and satisfaction. Because every human being has one primary goal in their life every single day, is to be happy and satisfied. That's what every human being wants. Every single human being has an ultimate goal in his life, and no one disagrees with that. All human beings, all mankind, Muslims, non-Muslims, religious, non-religious, believers, non-believers, atheists, so on, they all have one objective in life. And what's the objective? Is to live a happy life. That's why, as the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, "Kullu nasi yaghdu, kullu nasi yaghdu." All people from all race, from all kinds, from all religion, they all strive early in the morning. Every person is striving. Every person has a goal, and everyone aims to that same goal, which is happiness, satisfaction and contentment. But the difference is people have different ways to get to that goal. Everyone has one goal. All people, all mankind have one primary goal, is to be happy and to be satisfied. But there's different ways to get that happiness and satisfaction. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes to teach us the best, the greatest, the easiest, the smoothest, the most happiest way to get to that satisfaction and happiness. And what's that? Islam. How? Following the halal. Yes. Following the halal. Following the halal. A principle that many Muslims are asleep. Many Muslims are sleeping. I'm neglecting this principle. Following the halal. What does halal mean in your life? Do you live your life like who the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, everyone strives, some free themselves, some beslave themselves, people follow the halal and the haram, and people only follow the halal. Which category do you fit in? Are you from amongst those who wants to obtain happiness, satisfaction, contentment through the halal and only the halal? Or are you the other type that does not care if it's halal or haram? You don't care if it's halal or haram, as long as you possess it, as long as you acquire it, as long as you earn it. You don't think of that dollar that's in your pocket or in your wallet or in your bank. You don't think if that's through a halal mean or haram mean. A Muslim lives his life only according to the halal, and only acquires halal, and only eats halal, and only drinks halal, and only clothes himself in halal, and only lives in the halal, and only accepts the halal, because the halal is the only way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the life of the Muslim.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سواه.